All right, everyone, the score is set. The game is being played, and the stage is epic.
Narazim Crypt.
Narazim Crypt.
In case you were trying to go for the map name.
No, I was just going for drama. Yeah, thanks for ruining it. This is Narazim Crypt. I am Neutral Chaotic Duke, and this is Nick Cervantes Brown.
Yeah, I'm glad to be here.
We are pumped to be here. This has been a very good series between Ridal and CrAzian, as good as the LIG could ever hope to produce.
Indeed.
So, first game, exciting. Second game, short but exciting.
Third game, hopefully exciting.
Third game cannot be a dud, because this is the tiebreaker. I'm pretty sure both players are pretty evenly matched on our ladders right now, too.
Actually, they're all tied up, now that you mention it.
So this is going to be not only a tiebreaker for the series, but a tiebreaker on the standings as well. So,
indeed. And
I know last game I was, you know, having a little hissy fit about scouting too early. This is a little bit interesting. Ridal is grabbing a fairly early gas. It's already done. He's already sending SCVs in there. So we might see maybe like a Reaper harass or something like that.
Actually, CrAzian gets a little bit of an early gas himself. Not quite as crazy early, but he's only at 12 supply when he put down that assimilator.
Yeah, that is pretty early. Maybe he's going to make sentries this game. I don't know.
Maybe he's rushing Colossi this game.
Maybe
who would have expected that?
Maybe a DT fast expand. Who knows? One can only hope. CrAzian does get the probe inside. He's going to get a nice little scout off here. And nearly at the same time, the SCV will be rounding the corner and entering the base.
The Twilight Zone.
The Twilight Zone, indeed. So,
and now neither player is actually building anything, which is kind of an odd thing to see at the beginning.
I think Richard wanted to wall off before.
Oh, CrAzian has 400 minerals, and he's just now putting down the cybernetic score. I don't know if he was distracted with microwaving a probe somewhere or something, but
yeah.
And he actually gets the complete wall off, so he can kill this SCV in here this time. Or is Richard just fighting?
I think Richard's. Oh, did he get a complete wall off?
I'm not good enough to tell.
I'm not sure if that was intentional or not.
I just find it strange that the SCV turned around to fight, so I don't know if Richard meant to do that. And we also have the proxy pylon going down on the low ground. How he intends to get vision on the high ground remains to be seen.
He can get an observer out or something like that. I think the bigger issue is that this barracks right here is going to spot it.
Absolutely, and Richard's camera immediately focuses on that pylon, and that will be the end of that pylon.
And pew pew, Space Marines, that pylon is going down.
Yep, and we see right now Krasian's holding the important Zelnaga Tower. He will be able to see any troop movement coming out, except he pulls the probe.
He just heard you say that, so now he's going to...
He's going to go place a noob pylon, proxy pylon.
Did you say a noob pylon?
A new...
Okay, I thought you said noob pylon.
Oh, actually, I think that's very good placement in this particular match.
It is a very good placement. It's behind the trees a little bit. I'm not sure, but I think if you place it like directly behind the trees, like right here, it's really hard to get vision on it. So, but this should also be a very good spot.
Yeah, I can't imagine the army moving up anytime soon. And we have a floating barracks. Is it a scouting barracks or is it a proxy barracks?
Where is it landing? Does it have a landing site yet? It does not have a landing site.
I would not be surprised at all to see Richard placing this in the this middle mineral patch or somewhere nearby. He can run up Marines from behind.
He might have also... I didn't see which barracks he lifted off. I think I had to assume it's the one that built the tech lab, because he is now going for a pretty fast... Well, actually, I don't know Terran builds that well. I think he's going for a pretty fast siege tech. So,
He is building a tank, so I would assume as much. And siege research actually is almost nearly done. So, if you were looking at the production tab, you would know that.
Mm-hmm. Which I am.
There we go. And so we have siege tanks. We have a floating barracks coming into this base over here, and a handful of Marines.
I would really like to know what Krasian's going for. If it's really going to be a 4-gate, it's a very, very delayed 4-gate.
In fact, it's a 5-gate at this point. And only one cast too, which is pretty unusual for this stage.
Yeah, it's almost like a zealot all in, which
And now
against
he's that
Terrans.
is exactly what he's doing. He's got four zealots and a stalker at his proxy. I think he's just going to run in and hope that most of Richard's army is out of position, which it will be.
Now he can stop this command center from landing, which would be really good. Unless he runs into this tank, which would be really bad. But yeah, I think this is actually going to be another very, very lucky timing from CrAzian. Unfortunately, he does have a siege tank now sieged up around his base, which is never a good thing. And the Parax is actually going
And
to
here we
spot
go.
The high ground.
Immediately destroys the proxy. Richard chooses to... I'm not sure what he's going to do yet. Is he going to go for the base race, or is he pulling back?
I'm not sure, but CrAzian actually forced Richard to not lower the... Richard is again going to be flying all his production units up, up, and away.
Absolutely. And where did all the SCVs go?
They're
oh, they all
here.
Pulled to the left side.
They're hanging out on the side.
So Richard's now going to land the barracks in CrAzian's base. He is going to go for the base race. And with his floating buildings going everywhere, he actually has a pretty strong chance of this succeeding.
Yeah. Again, Richard is depowering buildings, which is always a good thing. I'm kind of surprised that he hasn't moved. Yeah, I was going to say, his siege tanks haven't really moved up. So we'll see what
happens. And now CrAzian's going to chase down the SCVs, and which I guess now Richard's being revealed.
I was going to say, both players are sitting on a veritable plethora of minerals. So
yeah. Well, what happened there for CrAzian was he got supply blocked when that first pylon got taken down. Oh, and then when all Richard has to do is pull back his Marines, and the siege tank on the low ground absolutely tears up the Stalkers.
Yeah, I can't really see how this is going to go in CrAzian's favor.
Oh, and he loses the vision because the base has been rebuilt. I don't know what
I'm
is going
sure
on.
What he's doing. Yeah.
The placement of the siege tanks and landing, that is a fantastic strategy. I don't think I've seen that before.
Maybe he's hoping that the splash damage from the siege tanks will hurt Richard's own buildings. I'm not sure. Ooh, that Marine just got sliced and diced.
Absolutely. And Richard's still constructing that command center. And now Steven brings Stalkers in. I don't think he might get one tank. One tank goes down.
He needs to move the other one. He should have enough to break the siege tank, the second siege tank, if he can just, yeah, move the
Zealots
over.
Close. And now we have a Hellion. I don't even know what's going on anymore. The tanks are down. All he needs to do is repel the forces in his base and hope that Richard doesn't re-macro up really fast. Yeah. But the Zealots are just hanging out on the low ground, not sure what they're doing.
He does have plenty of Stalkers to take care of this army. But yeah, I mean, this is a really, really a wacky, wild show.
I have thoroughly, and Richard quits out. Wow.
Wow. That's all I can say about that one, folks. Wow.
There are no words.